Welcome to your how-to video, which will explain how to write your first body paragraph. Now, it's important before you start writing to remember the purpose of your essay. And the purpose of this essay has three components. The first is to share the historical and literary information about your location. Therefore, your first body paragraph is going to be about historical information or literary information. The sample paragraph that you see today will be about historical information. The third purpose of your essay, and also a purpose of this first body paragraph, will be to convince people to come tour your location. Therefore, in this first body paragraph, we are focusing on historical information, and then also creating interest so people want to see the location that you're focusing on. Now, the format for your body paragraph will include the following sentences. Your first sentence will be the topic sentence, which will introduce and overview what the entire body paragraph will be about. Your second sentence will introduce evidence and will have an in-text citation. Your third sentence will elaborate the evidence that you introduced in the previous sentence. Your fourth sentence will provide evidence number two and will also have an in-text citation. And then the next sentence will elaborate upon that evidence you just introduced. And your last sentence will transition into what your next body paragraph will be about. Now, to start, let's start with our topic sentence, the first sentence of our first body paragraph. Now, when I write my topic sentence, I have to remember what I'm writing about. So in this case, I'm writing about O'Connell Street. I also will then need to remember the jigsaw terms when I did my historical research. And these are the jigsaw terms that I had to look up. Please remember that your location and your jigsaw terms are going to be different than the ones we cover in this video. This video is an example of what you'll do, but you'll need to use your own location and terms when completing your own first body paragraph. Now, for my paragraph, I need to figure out which jigsaw terms I'm going to talk about. I think for my first body paragraph, I'm going to talk about Saxville Street and Daniel O'Connell because I feel like they go well together. That means in my second body paragraph, I'll talk about James O'Conley, the 1916 Easter Rising, and Saturday, 29th of April. Now, let's write your topic sentence. For my topic sentence, I would write, O'Connell Street's historical significance begins with its namesake, Daniel O'Connell, who made great strides in peacefully gaining Catholic emancipation and Irish freedom. So the important parts of this topic sentence are as follows. I introduce what my location is, O'Connell Street, and I overview what type of information I'm going to talk about, and that's historical information. Then I introduce the focus of this paragraph, which will be Daniel O'Connell, and then I show my two sub-focuses, the Catholic emancipation and Irish freedom. From this topic sentence, it is clear what my entire paragraph is going to be about. It's going to be about historical significance, specifically with Daniel O'Connell, and I will explore both the Catholic emancipation and Irish freedom within my paragraphs. So your topic sentence should achieve the same goals. After you write your topic sentence, now before we go on, I would suggest pausing on this page about your topic sentence and then going and actually writing your topic sentence, as opposed to watching this video all the way through. However, you can do it however you want. However, if you've written your topic sentence, let's now go to the next section. So the next sentence that you'll write is evidence number one, and you'll need to include an in-text citation. So when thinking back to my topic sentence, I mentioned Catholic emancipation and Irish freedom. The information about the Catholic emancipation is going to be what my first piece of evidence is about. So I want to make sure that the way that I show my information in my topic sentence matches the way that my information is shown in my first body paragraph. So now with my first piece of information on the Catholic emancipation, I would follow my topic sentence with, for example, O'Connell, despite domineering British opposition, was elected to the British House of Commons. From this hard-earned position of power, he achieved Catholic emancipation, where Catholic Irish gained equal rights in a Protestant-run Ireland. And that was written by Hanley on page 3. Now, the things to note about evidence when you're adding it into your first paragraph is that I use a transition. So you're always going to start your evidence sentences with, for example, or for instance, or research shows, some kind of transition that will indicate to your readers that you are going to provide researched information. Then I add in my own terms. You want to make sure that your evidence isn't vague or overgeneralized. And a way to do that is to make sure that you're bringing in specific facts, whether it's places, or people, or dates. Then I get onto my topic that's been promised by my topic sentence, and I talk about the Catholic emancipation. And then last but not least, since this information is researched, I make sure to put the author's last name and the page number. If you cannot remember how to do in-text citations, please refer back to your main page of the Moodle, because there's information on how to do works cited pages and in-text citations there. Now, please pause and actually write the sentences for your evidence number one. Once you've completed that, you'll move on to elaboration. Now, if you think back to your evidence number one, your elaboration will explain why this research information is important. When you write your elaboration, all of this should be your own ideas. It should be opinionated. It should be your reflection upon the research that you found. You should never have to use an in-text citation for elaboration because you're using your own ideas, not that of another author. So your evidence will be other people's ideas that you use an in-text citation for. Elaboration is your ideas as to why that research is significant. So for my elaboration, I write, "This made O'Connell a hero because the Catholics had been denied the ability to own land and vote by British Protestant rule. The Catholic Irish also had suffered from heavy, unfair taxing. O'Connell made life easier and safer for Catholics throughout Ireland." So what I've done is I've taken the evidence and I've explained why, in my opinion, this is important for people to know. So the way that I show its significance is I say that that research proves O'Connell is a hero. And then I follow by explaining why this makes him heroic. And all of this information comes from my own brain and is my own opinion. Now, please stop and write your elaboration sentences. Once you've written your elaboration, you'll move on to your second piece of evidence. This should be easier because you've already written an evidence sentence. So this is your second time around. Now, when I think back to my topic sentence, I promised my readers that I was going to talk about how the Catholic emancipation made Daniel O'Connell important, and also how the Irish freedom made Daniel O'Connell important. So my second piece of evidence is going to be about the Irish freedom. Now, what I'm going to write about the Irish freedom is also, O'Connell was known for beginning the push towards Irish freedom from Britain. He pushed for a repeal of the Union Act that had merged the parliaments of Britain and Ireland. Despite being imprisoned for his views, O'Connell fought against the Union Act until his death. And this was written by Trevor on page 5. Now, important things to notice is, first, I again use a transition word. When you get to your second piece of evidence, you need to indicate that you're moving on to another subtopic. Words such as additionally and also can act as these transition words. Also, I introduce my next subtopic, which is going to be the Irish freedom, and I provide information as to what O'Connell did And then I add my in-text citation, the author's last name, and the page number, if there is a page number. Now, please take a moment to pause and write your second evidence sentence. Once you're done with that sentence, you'll move on to your second piece of elaboration. You'll want to think back to your second piece of evidence and ask yourself, why is this significant? Why is this important? And this is what I wrote. I wrote, though O'Connell did not succeed in repealing the Union Act, his life dedication to the freedom of Ireland set up a framework for later rebellion and policy change. So admired was O'Connell for his efforts that Sackville Street, a major thoroughfare in Dublin, was named after him. The things to note for my elaboration is that I state why the information I just shared was significant, and I do so with my own opinion. I then also add that this is why Sackville Street, another one of my terms, was named for O'Connell, which further proves why the information about Irish freedom was significant. Now please take a moment to pause and write your elaboration explaining why your evidence 2 is significant to your paper's purpose. Once you're done with your elaboration, you can move on to the final sentence of your first paragraph, which is the transition. Now when you transition, the purpose is to set up what you'll talk about in your second paragraph so as to connect your first paragraph to your second. So for instance, I wrote, O'Connell's Catholic emancipation and fight for Irish freedom makes O'Connell Street an important location to visit in Ireland, for it provides the historical background and setting for the infamous events in Ireland's timeline towards freedom, including the 1916 Easter Rising. So what's significant about this sentence is that it reviews what we talked about in the paragraph, those two important subtopics. Then I include the overall purpose of my essay, which is to convince people to visit O'Connell Street. And then last but not least, I mention what I will talk about in my second historical paragraph. And I know what I'm going to talk about from my leftover jigsaw terms. So I'm going to focus in on the 1916 Easter Rising in my second history paragraph, but I will likely mention James O'Connelly and Saturday, 29th of April in that paragraph as well. Now, once you've written your topic sentence, your evidence 1, your elaboration of evidence 1, your evidence 2, your elaboration of evidence 2, and your transition, you will have a complete and thorough first body paragraph. Now, if you would like, please pause on this slide, and you can use it as an example of how you would create your own first body paragraph. Your first body paragraph may not be exactly like this. It might be shorter, it might be longer, but ultimately it should follow the steps and have these 6 components. All right, I hope this helps. If you do have any questions, please make sure to email me, or I will be in my classroom at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. Good luck with writing your first body paragraph, and please make sure to share or email the paragraph to me. Have a great night. Bye.